campaign on the deplorable state of the temples in Tamil Nadu continues. The temple lands in Tamil Nadu are being illegally grabbed. Temples are being bulldozed and razed to the ground. Many statues have been stolen and others are corroded, suffering from what is known as bronze cancer. Well, yesterday NewsX had raised the matter with many members of parliament from Tamil Nadu who either evaded the question or floated the probe rhetoric. Today we bring to you yet another story, this time of the Ahasthevar Venkateshwara Perumal Temple in Chennai, where 14 acres of temple land have been reduced to only 2 acres. The question then remains, who is responsible for this loss and if the authorities and politicians will rise to the occasion and take action? Ram Kumar is joining us live with more details on this story. Ram, NewsX's investigations continue. What is the fresh development in this matter?
Well, we have done an extensive story on a temple which is located in Nungambakkam in Chennai. The temple called Agastheswarar Venkatesa Perumal Temple, located in Nungambakkam. And this particular temple holds a very rich heritage and culture of the Tamil tradition. It's about 500 years old and a beautiful pond in front of the temple. And as per the government record, this temple holds 14 acres of land as a patta land, and now it has been reduced to 2 acres. The rest 12 acres of land now have been sold to many private individuals, and from 1792 this temple was administrated by many trustees. Over the period of 50 years that under the administration of these trustees, they have sold the temple land at various stages to many private players. Now you could see the temple lands fully occupied by various commercial establishment and private buildings. And in 2014, this matter has brought to the HRNC department, who are the solely responsible for to manage the temples across the state, but they have not taken any action. And similarly, they have filed a petition before the Madras High Court, and the matter is now lying on the Madras High Court. And on the other side, with all the evidence that right from the government document that establishes that the particular temple itself holding a 14 acres of land, and on the various stages it has been sold out to many private players, and we have an RTI copy which reveals that the government itself on record stating that the 12 acres of the temple land sold out to many private people, but no action from the HRNC. And all the evidence also been produced to them. What the petitioner certainly feels that the section 77 of the Hindu religious and charitable endorsement, they have a special power to evacuate people who occupy the temple land, and even if it is illegally sold to some the private players, with exercising that special power, the HRNC department can reacquire the land. But they have not done that. Now the matter is lying under the Madras High Court. They have directed the HRNC department to get a legal opinion. The matter now posted to January 7th. So the status quo is continuing. It is such a beautiful temple which is located at the prime locality of Chennai. We had visited to the temple, and now only the pond and the temple building is remaining. There was initially a 4 entrance for the temple. Now it is only 2. So all the surrounded, the 4 sides of the temple now fully occupied and illegally sold out. So the devotees are really finding a tough time to enter into this temple. So like this, there are many temples across the state now is under, lying under the encroachers, aggressors, and in many cases it has been occupied by even politicians. But no action has been taken from the concerned HRNC. So all the many PLs now bending before the Madras High Court. Now all the activists who are involved in the movement to reacquire the temple's land are now hoping that the Madras High Court will take this matter up seriously and will do some justice to them. Back to you.
Stay with us, Ram Kumar. We are now going to play out the ground report that you filed from this particular Ahasyavar Venkateshwara Perumal Temple in Chennai.
Behind me, the beautiful Agastheswarar Venkatesa Perumal Temple, which is located in Nungambakkam in Chennai. And this particular temple holds a very rich tradition of the Hindu culture and the Tamil culture. And it's about 500 years old of the heritage. And you can see a beautiful pond in front of the temple. And initially, there was a 4 entrance for this temple. Now it is restricted to only 2. And as per the government record, this temple holds 14 acres of land itself. But over the period of past 50 years, the trustees of the temple who were administering this temple from 1792 has been sold the temple property on various stages. At present, this temple only holds 2 acres of land out of 14. The 12 acres of land around the temple, now we can see, now emerged as a commercial establishment and other private buildings. Around the temple, now it's clearly a complete violation of the HRNC guidelines, and also the trustee who sold the 12 acres of land to the private individuals. Now, in 2015, this matter brought up to the HRNC with all evidence. Uma Anandan has filed a complaint before the HRNC, but no action has been taken even in the last 3 years. Similarly, a writ petition also filed before the Madras High Court, and the Madras High Court directed the HRNC to come up with a legal opinion on January 11th. On the other side, the Section 77 of the HRNC, the Act, the Special Act, clearly says that the department can exercise a special power to evacuate the people who occupied or illegal sale of the temple land can be revoked after serving a notice. Within the 1 month period, they can evacuate the people and reacquire the land. But the HRNC has not taken any action. Now the matter is lying in Madras High Court, so the status quo is still continuing. With video journalist Balasubramaniam, this is Ram Kumar for NewsX in Chennai.
I'm going to file a petition in the High Court. It should be done in a matter of about a week or so. Everything is ready. I'm going ahead because nearly about 1,000 crores today, it has been alienated. And we can do so much for the poor children of Nungambakkam.
The HRNC is not using their inherent power. Now, they cannot even give the legal opinion also now, because there is no documents with them. To give a legal opinion, they should have documents. They are clearly given in writing. They don't have any sale documents to look into the sale, how the sale was occurred and all. But they say some technical reason they are saying the properties were sold under Chennai City Tennis Corporation.
Ram Kumar, still live with us for more details on this story. Ram, any answers from the authorities, any answers from the government after you have, of course, given, fresh examples of how temple land has been looted, how temple land has been plundered? The prime example, this new temple you've investigated at Nungambakkam.
Well, when we tried to establish the contact with the commissioner of the HRNC, but he refused to give any comment. And also we tried the executive officer of this particular temple, Agastheswarar temple. He also refused for any comment. So this matter is completely, the violation of the HRNC guidelines. And also it seems the government is not very serious about this issue. Even after many PILs filed before the Madras court with many evidence. In fact, we could see all the petitions filed before the Madras High Court in connection with the temple lands that were occupied and encroached by many people that are submitted with all the evidence and the documents. And in the government record itself, in fact, in that particular issue, the RTI replay, which completely reveals that how the temple lands have been sold to private players on various stages. They have mentioned within a year and how much of the acres land sold to the private people. But even after having all those details, the department is not taking any stringent actions. But now only with some activists, some devotees who come forward and taken this initiative to filing the petitions before the court and giving complaint to the HRNC. And in fact, in this particular issue, we have got the copy of the complaint which was lodged before the HRNC in 2015. But the petitioner has got no response from the HRNC department. Even after the summon which was issued by the Madras High Court for 4-5 times, the commissioner or the concerned executive officer didn't turn up to the hearing. So that is the worst thing that we have been seeing in related to this case. So after our intensive campaign of this bringing back the temples land that are belongs to the Hindu temples, at least now the government should wake up and should constitute a separate body or a tribunal to look after that cases that are related to that are connected to the temples lands that were encroached, and then idols theft, that is especially. And the government record itself stating that at least 1,200 ancient idols that were stolen from the Tamil Nadu temples in at least last 25 years. So that is the worst scenario now relying under the Hindu temples in Tamil Nadu.
All right, unfortunately it seems we've lost Ram Kumar there, but we will continue to track this story for now.